Praxis Prepper.
Hey YouTube, this is Praxis Prepper, and I wanted to relay something that happened to me the other day that was really weird, and I think it's worth noting. We've all been listening to the debate going on about, there's just more and more school shootings all the time. And the strange thing that happened to me the other day was that I was listening to Donald Trump's opinion on it, and I thought to myself, that's a pretty good idea. That's actually exactly what I've been thinking on the topic. That's a very unusual event, but I'm always open to it. Even if I think some politician is a whack job, which is sort of where I was going with Donald Trump, I'm always open to being surprised, and I like Donald Trump's approach to the school shooting situation. Is it perfect? No. And I certainly don't like the aspect where he talks about paying teachers to carry firearms. I think there'll be enough altruistic people that are concerned for their own safety and the safety of the children that they work with that I don't think we're going to have trouble having volunteers. But the general idea of having teachers carry weapons into schools, the ones that want to do it, not forcing people to do it. Again, not forcing people to do it by making them feel like they'll get more money if they're packing heat. I don't think it would be right to financially incentivize it in that way. I think it needs to be something that people do because they want to do it for the right reasons. That and raising the age on firearms, I think those are good ideas. They've got downsides to both of them, and I'll talk about those in a bit, but really, it's the most sensible idea in the room at the time, which is really weird because it's coming out of Donald Trump's lips. A lot of the other talk is you got on one side this like one less movement where people are chopping up their weapons, and taking pictures of it so they get credit for having done it and sharing that around. And then on the other side, you got like the whole like, well, let's go back to the 1950s and leave it to Beaver because we didn't have school shootings back then. With lynchings and things like that back then, if you were the wrong race. But those are both fantasy-based ideas. Let's talk about the one less movement first, because that was right in my thumbnail. I used that. That is pure fantasy. It's theatrics, because it's not going to do anything. If I chop up my AR-15, which is, locked in its security box and everything like that, I'm not going to prevent anything from happening any more than if you went back in time to the days of Jack the Ripper and everyone broke up their kitchen knives, that they were going to somehow stop Jack the Ripper from what, he was doing. I know there's old conspiracy theories on Jack the Ripper. Let's just pretend it was one person, whatever. Destroying weapons that aren't used for crime is not going to, prevent crimes. It's just going to, destroy a bunch of weapons. It's theatrics, it's a show. And real kids are dying, and we need more than theatrics in a show. On the other side, you got people saying, let's all go back to the 1950s. Everything was fine back then, before our culture got co-opted, and, let's blame immigrants and all this other foolishness. That's ridiculous, because we're not going to go back to the 1950s. In the same way that we're not going to get rid of all the guns. We are where we are. Maybe over time, our culture could develop in more peaceful ways, and maybe over time we have less firearms, and we could talk about whether that's a good idea or a bad idea. I think it's probably a good idea, but that's not going to happen right now. We have what we have, we're facing what we're facing, and we need something that's going to save people now, not 30 years from now. And I think Donald Trump's approach to it's the most sensible one that I'm hearing. I know a lot of people are going to be irked by the whole, like, you have to wait till you're 21 to purchase a firearm. But, I mean, the age of 18 is so arbitrary as well. I know the argument is that, well, like, if a kid that's 18 can be drafted into the service and go off to a foreign country and, fight a war over there with weapons, why can't they have a firearm to protect themselves here? Well, I have some problems with people drafting or even, enticing to serve kids. I know that our military is one of the few militaries that hasn't really got on board with the whole child soldier thing because we like to recruit young. There's a reason for that. It's because kids don't think all that clearly and they're more likely to, take those sorts of risks. Science has proved that, and that is exactly the kind of reason why I think that it would probably be sensible to wait until these kids' minds fully develop, maybe if it's even past 21, but giving them a couple more years to develop their, rational cognitive skills so they can make these decisions. Now, are there 18-year-olds right now that would lose that right that are perfectly capable and perfectly responsible? Yes. There are also 17-year-olds and 16-year-olds right now that are probably more responsible than a lot of 30 or 40-year-olds, but they can't currently buy a firearm. We have to set the line somewhere, and whereas science suggests that the majority of kids are still developing when they're 18, 19, 20, into 21. why not wait a couple of years if it can make some sort of a difference? I know it sucks for certain people, but I think it would also be, you know, beneficial to the overall picture and protect a lot of people as well. So it's really unusual, but on this, me and Trump are pretty close. Again, like I said, there are some aspects of what he's talking about, especially the idea of paying teachers extra in order to be, you know, bring guns into school. I don't think that's a really good idea. I think that it needs to be something people do, you know, from the heart, something that they think is important, and not something that they feel they need to do in order to make less money. In order to make more money, because we all know teachers are not really all that well paid, you know, generally speaking, and I don't think we want to create some sort of situation where a teacher feels like, well, you know, in order to make rent next month, I think I should start bringing a gun to school. I think it has to be done by people that, you know, that want to be doing that. But other than that, you know, even if Trump's idea isn't where we end, I think it's a good start to the conversation, and I'm ready to stand behind other ideas that he has if I don't think that they're like crazy batshit nuts. But this is a rare event. Anyway, that's it. Tell me what you guys think in the comments below. Again, I know there's a heated issue. Keep it civil, and you may actually convince some people of your points. You know, just throwing out names and stuff like that doesn't do anything other than make you look silly and eventually get you blocked from my channel if you just can't calm it down. Keep it civil. Keep it grown up. So that's it. Let me know what you think in the comments below. This is the beginning of a conversation, but it's an important one. We really need to solve this because this is just getting crazy. I know there's other things. I mean, people die. More people get killed from, like, you know, fast food and cars than guns, but getting massacred in a school is a pretty awful way to go, and I think we'd all like to see that one at least get relegated to further down the list of likely causes in the United States. That's it. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe and tune in every Friday at 4:30 New York time for a new video. And if you'd like to support this channel, you can do so both through Patreon or PayPal.